Hello friend, this is Jimmy from Can Have an Immigration Canada. In this video, I'm going to update you guys about the Rural Northern Immigration Pilot Program. One of the community has held its first RNIP draw. Like this draw is same as when you guys put your profile into the express entry and the government hold the draw. Again, same thing in this municipality draws like this in Rural Northern and Immigration Pilot Program. One of the communities from Ontario, Sudbury, they have recently launched this Rural and Northern Immigration Pilot Program and they held their first draw. They have invited few potential candidates to apply under their RNIP program who have got selected by some of the local employers for the job opportunities in that community. Sudbury, Ontario held its first RNIP draw on April 23rd, inviting candidates to apply for a community recommendation for Canadian permanent resident. This is one of the largest cities in Northern Ontario with a population of 165,000. Now, if we look at a lot of the other communities, total there are 11 communities who are participating in RNIP. And has its own method of selecting immigration candidate. Sudbury used the point-based system, much like any provincial nomination or the federal express entry system. The Sudbury RNIP select the highest ranking candidate from the pool of applicant and invited them to apply for the community recommendation. And after that, they will be able to apply for the provincial nomination and the permanent resident for Canada. Sudbury issued 6 invitations to eligible candidates who had a minimum score of at least 280. In this, also the tie-breaking rule was applied, meaning if more than one candidate has a lower score, the cutoff would be based on the date and time they submitted, as same thing as in the express entry. In this draw, the cutoff date was April 15th and 4:20 p.m. local time, the Ontario time. Sudbury's program was launched on March 23rd, and this program is foreigners and their families who want to live in Sudbury for longer term. Candidate must have secured an offer of employment in the eligible occupation in an eligible industry. So now there are only 3 RNIP communities that are not accepting application at this time. These are Moose Jaw in Saskatchewan, North Bay, Ontario, West Kootenay in the British Columbia. Moose Jaw's program was originally scheduled to begin in April, but due to the current circumstances, they have been postponed. North Bay has delayed opening its program due to the current situation again, and West Kootenay RNIP program expected to be launched in the month of May. But let's see if, according to current situation, whether they will be able to launch it or not. One of the most important pieces to know about the RNIP is that it is for the individual and families who want to live in Sudbury long term. There has been told by the city of the Greater Sudbury, one of their immigration department. It's not an easy pathway for permanent residency. It's a challenging to get a community recommendation and lengthier than gaining permanent residency through the express entry. So all the program has their own pros and cons. So unlike the CRS score used by express entry system, Sudbury RNIP award candidate the most point who earn between the age of 30 and 45. Candidates get more point with age because the RNIP is meant for the address local labor shortages. Generally speaking, it's on the short on the individual with the 10 to 15 year of work experience. So express entry currently prioritize individuals under 30. We also want candidate to look for express entry before assessing the Sudbury. That what has been told by the city of Sudbury's Department of Immigration. Candidate who are sure that the Sudbury is right term, right place for them to live with their family, may then start looking for a job in one of the 20 eligible in-demand occupation. They also have their own in-demand occupation list. If you still want to apply, you can still fill out your application. The online criteria is still open for anybody who fall under those categories. Same thing, they will look for your age, qualification, experience, language proficiency, and all other measures set by the federal government. So that was a little update. So RNMP has officially first issued the invitations to apply for their PNP, then permanent residence program for the province in the province of Ontario, and after that they will be eligible to apply for the federal work and the federal PR program. So it was a little update about the RNIP program. I'll keep you guys updated if there'll be anything else comes up. Till then, you guys all have a good day. Thank you.